The next method of dredging that we have been studying the different types. So in that, the next method which we will cover today is the horizontal auger dredging. Now, this horizontal auger dredging is very similar to what we had seen in the last lecture about the cutter head dredging. So in the last lecture, we had seen that cutter head dredging is nothing but in this you have a dredger or a floating barge over which you have a cutter head, which is projected like this in a horizontal manner, having some angle to the head, and this head is then lowered into the water body till it reaches the bed. And once it reaches the bed, this cutter head, it rotates in a particular direction, excavating the material, and simultaneously there is a suction pipe which we have seen in the left figure, the blue color one. So this suction pipe will extract all the excavated material. So that was the cutter head dredging. So on similar lines, we have this type, another type of hydraulic dredging, that is the horizontal auger dredging. Now in this, as I have mentioned, that it is very similar to the cutter head dredging. Only difference is whatever cutter head you had in the front, so now that is replaced by a horizontal auger type of thing. So you know what is an auger. You have studied in geotechnical engineering that it's a helical kind of instrument which is used to dig holes in the earth surface. So this auger, it is helical, or it has this helical blades. So it's vertical, what you have seen in geotechnical engineering. So here we are using a horizontal one, and this vertical or to these helical or spiral blades, you again have some small teeth like thing so that the excavation is done properly and you get all the material out of the place. So that is nothing but a horizontal auger dredging. Rest of it is very similar, that you have a ladder to which the horizontal auger is connected, and then that ladder is lowered into the water body using some hoist or a winch, and then after that your auger rotates, excavating the bed, and then there is a suction pipe which will extract all the excavated material, and then it is taken to the surface. Okay, so it's all, everything else is similar. Only difference is at the front side you have a horizontal auger in place of a cutter head. And the advantage of this is obviously that at a particular point of time you dredge more area. Okay. So in cutter head dredging we had seen that it dredges in somewhat this manner, that you have to rotate or move the cutter head in a particular direction so that it goes on dredging. So instead of that, if I use a horizontal auger over here instead of a cutter head, so obviously more area will be dredged at a same time, and then your dredging process, it will require less time. Whatever is the area that you have targeted for a day, that in a day you have to suppose dredge an area of 1,000 or 100 square kilometers, so that dredge area or that target will be completed in a less time if you use a horizontal auger dredging. So that's the only difference between cutter head and horizontal auger. The next important type of dredging, that is again a common and a widely used technique, that is a suction dredging, and in that also you'll find this very predominant trailing suction hopper dredger. Now from the word itself you can guess what will be suction dredging, that just by the suction action or a vacuum type of action you are excavating the material from the bed of the water body. So that is actually the suction dredging, and in that also, as I told you, the equipment that we use or which is widely used, it is a trailing suction hopper dredger. So I'll concentrate more on this trailing suction hopper dredger and then explain all the components of it, and that will give you an idea that what a suction dredging actually is. So here in this sketch above, you can see it's a line diagram, you can say, for a suction dredger. You can't much make out of it, but then too I have shown it just for the sake of understanding that how a drawing looks like. So this is the again sort of actual picture. The lower half, it is animated one, or you can say it's a painting type of thing. So this is actually your trailing suction hopper dredger. So what is the main component, or what are the components of it? So first component is a drag head, which is the one which you see at the bottom most, which is in contact with the bed of the water body. So this drag head, it is going to be dragged along the length or along the direction of your dredger, and while doing so, while being dragged, it sucks in the material which is there on the bed of this water body. Okay, so the movement, the forward movement is done, or there is a forward movement of this drag head along with the suction action, okay, or along with suction. So suction and forward movement, I'll just write here that forward movement and suction, it takes place simultaneously, and that takes place at this drag head component. It's a sort of main component for your suction dredging. The next important thing is you need a suction pipe, obviously. So whatever is the material that is being excavated, or if it is being sucked from the bed of the water body, so you will need to transfer it to the surface or take it above the surface. So for that you need that suction pipe, and obviously, like the previous dredging techniques, the suction pipe is capable of sucking the material because it has a motor fitted somewhere inside the dredger itself. Then you have the actual vessel which has hopper bins. We'll see in detail what is a hopper bin, but for now just hear out this term, that there is something called hopper bin, and this is the vessel, complete vessel, this blue red color whatever you see, that's the complete vessel or the dredger, you can say, and inside that you have hopper bins. And then this yellow color extensions that you see on the top side, these are the winches and hoist assembly. So this suction pipe and drag head, it's not like it is permanently below the water. You can lift it up. Generally, it is along, or it is above the surface of the water when not in use. And whenever you have to use it, you have to lower it to the bed of your water body. So the lowering and upward movement of this drag head and suction pipe together, it is done by the help of this winch and hoist assembly. Now winch, we have seen a lot of time before this now, so you are in a position to know what a winch is. Hoist is nothing but an arrangement which can lift and, or generally lift particular objects. So that is nothing but a hoist assembly. So combination of hoist and winch will allow you to lower your drag head suction pipe assembly and also take it up after the job is done. So these are the main components of your suction dredging or trailing suction hopper dredger. So the drag head, which is actually the surface which is in contact with your bed of the water body, and then the suction takes place over there. Then you have the actual suction pipe through which the material is taken to the surface, and that material which is taken through the suction pipe, it is holded, or for holding purpose this hopper bins are used. And then lowering of your suction pipe and drag head assembly, it is done by this winch and hoist assembly, which you can see over here, the ones that I am circling. So these are your winch and hoist assembly. Now the topmost figure on the left side, figure number 1, this is the closer view of your drag head. So as I told you, it has a dual role, that it has to scrape the surface or excavate the surface or the bed of the water body, as well as it has to suck in the excavated material. So for that, what is done is there is a water jet, sharp, small but sharp water jets are thrown at one side. So if you see figure number 1 and 2 simultaneously, figure number 1 on the left side, top left side, it is a animation, and figure number 2 on the top right side, it is the actual component, the drag head, but just it's in the process of installation, so you can't see the connections. Okay, so here somewhere you have the connections for the water jets. So those sharp water jets, they make sure that whatever is the surface or bed of the water body, it gets disturbed due to this sharp water jet. Okay. Disturbed as in it is sort of an excavating tool, you can say. And then you have a scraping edge, just like a shovel or a spade. So that scraping edge, it will collect all the, or it will be sort of a barrier kind of thing for your material which is excavated or which is being disturbed by this water jet. And then simultaneously there is a forward movement of your dredger. So as I told you, drag head, it has two movements going on simultaneously, or two actions are taking place simultaneously. The drag head is moving forward, and at the same time it is being, or the material which is there below it, it is being sucked. So on the right side also, if we see now this scraping edge, what you see here, it is having some teeth, red color teeth, you can see all over the width of your drag head. So if your material is a sandy one, a loose sand which can be easily excavated, so you just need water jets and a straight scraping edge. But if it is some stiff kind of material, stiff soil or stiff clay, you can say, so in that case it's desirable to have such teeth kind of scraping edge. So due to this teeth or the scraping edge and the forward movement, the material will be loosened, and simultaneously it will be get collected somewhere over here. Okay. And then simultaneously it will be sucked out of the place, and then it will be taken through this path, and here your suction pipe will be attached. So this is your drag head, and the bottom figures, if you see figure number 3 on the bottom left side and figure number 4 on the bottom right side. So figure number 3, as I told you, that this suction pipe and drag head, they are generally above the surface of water when they are not in use, and then when you have to use them, you just lower it into the water body, into the bed or at the bed level. So that is done by this yellow color assembly that you see here. So those are the assemblies for, or the those are the hoist and winch assemblies. So in figure number 4, if you see the winches or the hoist assembly, it is upright or it is straight. And the drag head, you can see here in figure number 4, the one I am circling. So this is the drag head, and it is attached to this suction pipe, which is black in color. Now this is in rest position, so that's why you see all the winches and hoist assembly, it is upright or straight. Now if I have to lower it down, or if I have to pull it from the water, or if I have to lower it down, suppose, so see the figure number 3. So for lowering, the winch assembly or the hoist assembly, now it has shifted. It was upright first, now it has tilted into or towards the water side, and then using the winch, free end of the winch, this free end is attached to this suction pipe at different locations, and then this whole assembly will be lowered down. So this is the way in which your drag head and the suction pipe, they are operated, or they are taken up and down, up to the surface of the, or the or up to the bed of the water body, and then by the action of water jet, the material is disturbed, and water jet plus the scraping action due to the forward movement of the dredger, that will help in loosening up the material, and then the suction pipe or the motor attached to the suction pipe, it will just extract whatever is the excavated material up to the top of the water surface. So this is the working of your suction dredging or the trailer suction hopper dredger. Yeah, so this is again a screenshot from the animation of a video animation is there. So this is screenshots of it. Now we can see there is a, this is the bed of the ocean, and you can see there is a sort of a drop or sort of a path which has been created. Now why this path is created? So we are simultaneously moving your dredger in this direction, and simultaneously there is a suction action, or simultaneously there is suction. So due to that, only the material which comes in below the drag head, that will be excavated and that will be taken to the surface. Okay, and you can just to widen your or understand your or visualize your suction dredging, you can assume or you can visualize it as a drag head as a huge vacuum cleaner. So all of you know what a vacuum cleaner is. So it's a equipment that we use to clean our houses or to suck all the dust from some surface. So this suction dredger is exactly like a vacuum cleaner, but on a larger scale. So this is the head of that vacuum cleaner, okay, through which all the suction takes place. And then this is the pipe of the vacuum cleaner, you can say, and then the material is collected. So in vacuum cleaner, you had, if you, those of you have seen a vacuum cleaner, so vacuum cleaner has a bag inside it. So all the dust or the waste material that you suck in, it is collected in that bag. So here we don't have a bag. Here, as the quantum is more, we have a hopper itself. Okay. So what's a hopper? We'll see. So this is the suction pipe. You can see the brown color material. That is nothing but the dredged material or the excavated material which is passing through the suction pipe to the top of the water. And this is the hopper that I was talking about. So whatever is the material or the suction sucked material, so obviously it will not be just sand or the solid material, there will be water, because we are directly sucking the material. We are not separating the material at the bed itself. We are sucking in all the water as well as the solid particles. Okay, so that's why you see it's, you can see it's a form of a slurry that is falling into the hopper bins. Okay, and these pipes, the these are the end portion of your pipe, suction pipe, okay, where there is an outlet kind of thing, and then all the slurry is collected in this hopper bin. Okay, this is the view, or this is what a hopper actually looks like. So this outline that I am just highlighting with red, so this is the actual outline of your ship. Okay, this is your actual ship, and then inside that ship you have such huge bins which are nothing but the hopper bins that I have been talking about for the past two slides. So these are your hopper bins, and in this hopper bins, if you see, now here is the drag head that you have, here is the suction pipe through which the material comes on the top side, and this is the motor which sucks in all the, or which creates that vacuum kind of effect. And then you see a net or pipes laid in linear fashion, and the at regular intervals the outlet of the pipes, they have, it has been left into the different hopper bins. Okay, so you have a single suction pipe on either side. So here you see you have two suction pipes. So generally assembly of two suction pipes you can see in a lot of trailing suction hopper dredger, but if the quantum of the work is very low, or if you use a small dredger, then you can have a single pipe as well. So whatever is the pipe assembly, single or double, So the outlet of the pipe, suction pipe, it is not just given to a single compartment. It is distributed equally to all the compartments, so that when you start collecting the material, the distribution of the load should be equal. Otherwise, one end of your ship, it might get more loaded, and then your ship will try to tilt. So that will disturb the dredging process. So that's why you see there are four bins over here. And if you even see the sizes of the bins, they are sort of symmetrical about this axis. If I draw a simple line, so you have one big and one small bin on the left side. So if I say this is the left side and this is the right side, so one small bin and one big huge bin on the left side, and similarly one small bin and one huge bin on the right side. So it gets balanced, the weight gets balanced, because we are distributing the dredge material equally in all the four bins. And now these bins, they will hold this material until we reach the destination. So this dredger is nothing but a sort of a ship. So once the dredging is completed, or once the excavation part is completed, then what is done is the drag head and the suction pipe, they are lifted using this winch and hoist assembly. And as you can see in figure number 4, then it is rested on the, or at the sides of the ship itself, or the sides of the barge or the hopper itself. And then your ship, it moves to the destination. Okay, so this is the photo from the transportation phase, that now you can see this, whatever I'm ticking, giving a red tick. So those are the top surface of your bins, hopper bins that I had just shown over here. So now they are loaded with the dredge material. You can see some black or brownish color material. And now that material will be transported to the desired location. If you have to reclaim a land in the sea itself at some another location, you have to travel it or transport it to there. And then you have to dispose it. So disposal also, you have different methods. So for disposal, the first method you see, the top most figure, that is called as the rainbowing. Rainbowing is nothing but, you can see the same vessel. Now whatever was stored in this bins over here, you have another pump over here, or another pipe, white color pipe you can see. So a pump is attached to it, and whatever is the stored material, it is now just pumped outside, and it is thrown in a form of a rainbow. Okay. The shape is, or the path of this is a rainbow. So that's why this action is called a rainbowing action. Okay. So here you see they are throwing that, or disposing that dredge material into the water itself. But now this will be the reclaimed land. Okay. So they are intending to create an artificial island over here. So that's why they are disposing of like this. So in Burj, in Palm Islands of Dubai also, the first photo of our third unit, if you recall, so you had seen somewhat similar kind of a picture. So that is called a rainbowing. So that is one of the method of disposal of your dredge material. The second way is, either if you don't want to dispose it in land itself, if you don't want to dispose it in water itself, and you have to take it on the land and dispose it to some area demarcated over there, so you lay a network of pipe, or a series of pipe connected to each other, and this pipeline is floating one. You can see the bottom left figure. So this is the pipeline, floating pipeline, and then it is floating over the water surface, and when it comes to land, it becomes a normal pipeline. And then you have some already excavated pits in which this material is just dumped. So this is called the reclamation area, where your dredge material will be just dumped, and it will stay there until it dries out, the water dries out, and then the soil may be used for some other purpose. Or another very preferred method is disposal through doors at the bottom of the surface of vessel. Okay. So whatever vessel you see, this vessel, by vessel they mean the barge or the hopper, it has different names. Okay. So this is the vessel So if you go underwater, so as we can't have the actual photo, so it's an animation only. So this is the underwater part of that vessel. So the bottom part is flat one, and it has openings to it, which can be controlled hydraulically or by any other means. So these doors, you can control the opening and closing of these doors. So once the hoppers are filled, and then you transport this material to a desired location. So you just open these doors, and whatever is the material, it will just drop under gravity, and then it will be dumped at some desired location or the desired destination at the bed. And once you get a sufficient height, means what I'm trying to say is, if suppose this is the bed of your water body, and you start dumping over here. This is your ship or vessel. This is the water surface, and you start dumping over here the dredge material. So now, after some time, there will be some deposition. A particular height will be attained, and once, suppose again, now I have to show you. Now this much height is attained, or this much material you have dumped. Now there is a less difference between the water level, top water level, and the dumped material top surface. So now this difference can be now covered by just this rainbowing action. So in that case, no need of opening the doors, because otherwise what will happen is, if you go on just dumping, so there will be a point when there will be no space for these doors to open. So it is dumped up to a particular level or height, and then the rainbowing action can be used for the further disposal. So that's the difference you can think about, that rainbowing action and disposal through bottom of the doors. So rainbowing action, if you just start doing the rainbowing action at this level itself, where this is the bed of your water body, and if you start just rainbowing, so you can't say whatever is the material you are dumping, it will go and settle here itself. It might also disperse and go and settle somewhere nearby. So to be sure that whatever is the location you want to dump, that gets reclaimed, or that land it raises. So for that, first we dispose it through the bottom of bottom doors, and then we use the rainbowing action. So this is all with the suction dredging. I hope you have understood. So just to quickly revise, so this is the vessel of suction dredging, trailing suction dredger. And why this trailing word is come into picture? Because, as I told you, that this drag head, or we are moving the vessel ahead, and simultaneously we are sucking out the excavate or sucking out the material from the bed of the ocean. So if you see the movement, so this drag head, it trails to this movement of your vessel. So that's why the trailing word is used there. And main components are a drag head, a suction pipe, a vessel with a hopper bins to store the material, and then a winch and hoist assembly to lower and move the suction pipe and drag head upwards and downwards. Then this is a closer view of your drag head, which has a scraping edge and a provision for water jets, small but sharp water jets, which will sort of excavate your bed. And then the scraping action, due to the forward movement of your vessel, that will also excavate the material, and simultaneously it will be sucked out through this suction pipe. And the winches assembly, winch and hoist assembly, it will be used to lower the suction pipe and drag head into the water, and also to remove it from water. So it is just like acting like a large vacuum cleaner. And then whatever is the material which you are excavating, you store it temporarily in the vessel itself, in the hopper bins. And then you transport it, and then you dispose it either by rainbowing, or either by a pipeline, or by just opening the bottom doors. So this is the last method that we had in the hydraulic type of dredging. So in hydraulic, we saw three types. First was the cutter head, second was the horizontal auger, and third is the suction dredging. So in all the three types, it was the category of hydraulic. So water was used in some way or the other, either in excavation or in transportation. Transportation by that means I am saying either for excavation or extraction, not transportation, extraction.